one-man show, honest.
No, I don't know.
That side, yeah. Right. Got water there. I forgot about the music. Shall we start again? At least for one thing, it never goes quite smoothly with me, but you all get a smile. So. Anyway, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Paul Christian Spiritualist Church. You have me, Sharon, again. And we also, our medium for today is our wonderful friend, Heather.
Thank you.
We all know Heather, Heather Goncalves. And it's so lovely to see her here today, and I've missed her so much.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, lovely to see. And obviously, welcome to those that are watching online. It's a lovely, beautiful day, and it's raised our spirits, and this is what we need at this time. So I'd just like to say welcome again. Big hugs to you all.
Yes.
Yeah. So anyway, I'd like to start the service and ask Heather for the opening prayer. Thank you, Heather.
And it's a lovely day today, so thank you for coming out. Shall we go into the silence, please? Can you hear me all right?
Yes. Can you speak up a little bit?
We go into the silence. Divine Creator, Great Spirit, we, your children, come before you. We thank you for the blessings of the day and all that brings. We thank you for the beautiful sunshine, for the light that surrounds each and every one, and for your bringing the love and the healing into this world at this very much needed time. We ask that you will bless each and every soul upon this earth, that you will bring them uplift and strength and healing, that through this storm of emotions and of hurt, of pain, of loss and loneliness, you will bring calm and peace, you will bring healing and comfort. You will help people rise above and see the beauty that surrounds them each and every day. You will help them walk through their storms of life and find that comfort, that happiness, that joy that is the end of each journey. May we pray for healing to all that need healing, whether it be mind or body or soul. May we pray for those in hospitals, comfort for the sad, upliftment and healing for those that have feel they have lost their loved ones. May you shine the way and light the way to show through all darkness. May you shine your light to lead them ahead, those that cannot find the way, knowing that you and your angels and your archangels surround and support and help, as do the loved ones, your loved ones from the spirit side of life. They are always around you, helping you and guiding you. May you bring peace, inner peace, that great peace that goes beyond all understanding. May you comfort and uplift. May your angels draw near to guide and assist and aid. And may you know, and may we know, that in this storm that we're going through, there will always be an end. There will always be the sunshine. There will always be the light of the day. And there will always be the sun after the rain. Touch each and every soul. Those going home with you, comfort them, knowing that life is eternal and love is eternal. And to those whose hearts are broken, please comfort them. To those that seek aid, help, peace, please bring. To those that are trying to find their way in life, please show. To those that are troubled or anxious or worried, please calm. May we pray for peace amongst the leaders, calm in this world, and an end to all their troubles, that your light may shine brightly upon all, and bring that peace and that healing. We ask a blessing on the animal kingdom too, as they sustain us, and always bless that Mother Earth too will receive your healing, for she sustains us. And may in this moment of time mankind learn to walk gently upon her, and to know the gifts that she gives us as the gifts that you give us too, the blessings of the sun, of the rain, of the air, and of the water, and we thank you for them. We ask, dear Father, that you will bring a blessing upon those here today, knowing that their loved ones in the spirit world are around them, that life is eternal, and as said, love is eternal. Please bless each everyone here, their loved ones and their families, and those, of course, that are watching. And please bring these blessings forward into time, that when thy lovely light shines once again upon this earth and the storm has passed, we can all unite again once again as brothers and sisters as we are. We thank you for all these things that you give. Bless always this sanctuary, and may it remain open to help, and may it always bring that light as is needed and when is needed. May we thank you once again. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Heather. I would all like to join us in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen. Thank you. I ask you for the reading and the address, Heather. Thank
you. Hello, it's beautiful. As I said, it's a beautiful day today, and it's lovely to see you all out. And the one thing I do speak about a lot is seeing beauty in things and finding your blessings, because even going through trials and tribulations that we're all going through, there are always, always the blessings. And that's what raises our spirits up. There's always the light of hope. There's always the sun after the rain, the day after the night. And I know that in these troubled times, it's very, very difficult. There are people passing that you know, there are people, knowing people that pass, you know that there's comfort needed, there's people working so hard and giving up so much. There's the fear of loss, there's the fear of hurt. But there is always, always a light that shines, whether it be a blessing, whether it be a kind word, whether it be a smile, whether it be a beautiful day like this. And the Creator brings all these things, and he brings all these things through love. And it's to uplift you all and to lift your spirits up, because when your spirits are lifted up, the whole world's lifted up. And when your spirits lifted up, your loved ones are lifted up. And when your light shines as they do when your spirits lift, because when you're up, your spirit shines brighter than ever, that brings a light on the earth. That will draw more help from the angels, from the archangels, from your loved ones and spirits, from your guides. I wrote this the other day. I was out, it's very beautiful, and I wrote this, and I hope you enjoy it. It's called Look for the Peace and the Beauty. Today was the beautiful day, and the sun shone warm, and the wind blew cool, and the sky was white, billowy clouds with blue that moved, the clouds moved across the sky gently. It was like a painter had painted a picture, and the painter was the Creator. So thank you for the blessings of breath, for our health and for our life, for the eyes to see and the ears to hear. And thank you for the beautiful moments and the time in which to contemplate what beauty you have all created. For you have all created beauty in some way or form. Whether it's through your kindness, whether it's your hope, for your love, for your positive thoughts, for your garden, you've all created beauty. And by the murmuring waters, I sat today watching the ever-sparkling diamonds, the sun on the water as it gently trickled by. The birds were singing. They were singing their springtime song, and the water was singing, the sun shining, like diamonds reflecting on the water, the Creator's diamonds, the diamonds of beauty. Today, on the journey home, a beautiful bright butterfly flew around. Butterflies bring in the sunshine of life, a message of joy, to live in the moment and to enjoy each moment. to be aware of the moment and to breathe in the beauty of the moment when you see it. I pray that others will find beauty and peace in their worlds and realize that it is there if you look for it. It is not how the things, your outside circumstances are looking. It is how you look at things. It is not the worries that are there. It's how you perceive, how you feel, and how you uplift yourself. We are all responsible for our light. We are all responsible for finding the blessings and the beauty. Us, each one of us. For we are all light bearers. We all bring that light into the world. And sometimes it is very, 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 very hard to find it. But it is there. And once you've found it, you will not let it go. Because your light will shine. And your light touches another light. Your family, your friends, your loved ones. But it also brings the light, the healing, and the help from the spirit worlds, from the angels, from the archangels, and from the Creator, into this earth, onto this earth, and to all situations where there's disease, where there's war, where there's trouble, where there's fears, where there's anxiety, where there's hurt, where there's grieving. And it's brought through love. So each one of us can bring that light greater into the world, as we feel is needed very much today. The Creator brings us peace and help and helps us not to worry. Beauty to show there is still beauty, even if sometimes we are in a dark and troubled place and the healing is all around us. If we look for this, if we look for things, we will find them. Sometimes we won't look for beauty when there are shadows around. And sometimes we create those shadows. And sometimes we like to stay in the shadows. And we don't even want to look for the light. But if we pass all our worries and our troubles straight to the Creator through prayer, through meditation, through just letting go and speaking from your heart, letting go, you will know, you will be uplifted, and you will start to see your beauty in life, in your life, in others' life, instead of fears. And you will start to see the beauty instead of your troubles and your shadows. Sometimes we create our own shadows. Sometimes we worry so much, we're anxious so much, we fear so much, that actually the shadow that is with us is our own. It isn't anybody else's. Because through life, we can have misguided, sometimes we're misguided by our own self. Instead of giving everything up and praying and asking the Creator to help, or releasing our hurt and our pain to the Creator and letting that shadow that has been our own shadow go, then more light can come within us and we can shine brightly. We struggle on in life until we can take no more, and then we ask for help. Why do we do this? Why don't we ask for help straight away? But we do, we all struggle, we've all done it, I've done it. We've all struggled on in life, and we hold on, and we want to let go, and we can't, and we don't, and we struggle, and we struggle, and we struggle. And then when we can take no more, we ask for help, which is a little bit, on our parts, late, because we get the peace, we get the healing that we ask for, we get the help that we ask for. So we could have not gone through all that hurt, all that stress, all that worry, because we get. When we let go and we ask for the Creator, we receive. It might not be in the way that we can understand, in the way we want it, but you receive. All prayers are answered. They're answered in the Creator's time. Our time, we think, perhaps is now, but the Creator sees that if it's waited for, it'll be more beautiful, it'll be a better way. There's always a better way. And it will always be answered, sometimes in a way that you cannot imagine and more beautiful than you can imagine. So we struggle on until we can take no more. Why? For God the Creator, his angels, or his angels, the energy, our guides are there to help us when they can, and our loved ones are in the spirit world. So as soon as we feel like we're falling, not after we've fallen down, but still after falling we will be helped, we'll always be helped. But they will help us, and they help us all along. Seeing beauty and peace in all conditions, even if they're the hardest conditions, and nobody judges anybody, what we all feel is uniquely to ourselves and no different. There is difference in each person and how we perceive things. So all pain, whether it's pains, fears, anxieties or worries, it is all different one to another. And that, going through that is very hard sometimes to find the peace. But please always know that your guides, your angels, your families around you, steering you on. Come on, look at this. Sometimes we'll even be feeling very sad, very low, and something comes in the head, maybe. You know, listen to that lovely music. Don't want to. You know, again it comes a little while later. Why don't you put that music on, because you'll feel better? Oh no. Why don't you go outside, because you'll feel better? No. Do you see? So we sometimes do it to self. Spirit world is all around us trying to help us. Trying to help us. Trying to lift us up. Music, sunshine, do something you like. Go out, go for a walk. It has been hard through these situations at this time. Of course it has been. But even if it's within your own home or your own family, try and look for the signs. Because some people say, oh, I don't get signs and I don't, my family aren't around me. They are. Especially through these last couple of years. Your family from the spirit world has been here closer than you can ever imagine. Constantly trying to lift you up, constantly trying to help you, constantly trying to go, oh, I'm here, we're here. We're not, you're not going through anything alone. You never ever will go anything alone. Always there is your loved ones around you, your guides, your angels, spirits always around to help you. So even now, you're not on your own. There is beauty and peace in this world, and whatever you may think of the world, your world, or people in the world, look for these hidden riches. Let your spirit shine and let the beauty and peace, the Creator, place there for you to be seen. Whenever it rains, know the sun will come out. And after night time comes the morn, and after the wind blowing comes the stillness, and after all storms come peace. There is a rainbow. There's always a rainbow. Look for it. There is hope always, for it is the golden rope on which to hold on to. There is peace. Welcome beauty and peace. Welcome hope. Welcome the Creator of all things and people into your life, and know no burden is not heavy enough for the Creator to lift from you, your loved ones, or the world. Know no heart is broken enough for the Creator not to mend, and know that no situation or shadows are too long or dark for the Creator not to bring sunshine, healing, and peace. Trust and believe. Give your worries, let go of your burdens, and remember beauty. And this will bring you, each one of you, deep healing. It brings hope and above all love, for with and in love all things are possible. All situations can be healed, broken hearts mended, troubles solved, a way to be found. There's always a way to be found through your troubles. There's always the light. Sometimes it can mean a change in direction in life, but there's always help there, and there's always a better way there for you. Look for the rainbow and the sun, and even when your life seems dark and lonely and cloudy, and the Creator and the angels will show you it, just lift up your hearts and you will see these things and many, many more. Lift up your heart and know that your loved ones in the spirit world still love and walk beside you. Lift up your hearts and you will see. It's easier for your loved ones. They're always with you. But when you're feeling up, a little bit uplifted, it's easier for the spirits to connect, your spirit to connect with theirs. They're there. They're that close to you. But you sometimes don't feel them. But when you're uplifted, you can feel their energy more. You can feel them around you more. Lift up your heart and see the Creator brings peace, love, and healing eternally. So I say, may the rainbow shine upon all your pathways, and may the wind blow away all your troubles, the healing of beauty and peace. And may the Creator heal all your hearts and your loved ones, for knowing the Creator brings you love and life, and love and life is eternal. Thank you.
Wow, what an inspiration. I always love listening to Heather, because I know that all her readings are inspired and written by her, and she is such an inspiration, and all the love and healing that comes from her. Thank you, Heather. And talking about love and healing, we now go into that part of our service of healing, which is a great facet of our belief. We can all heal, we can all send sympathy and empathy to whoever comes in contact, we come in contact with. So for the moment, if I ask you to sit quietly and send out your thoughts of love to all those that you know that need healing, that need support, but also don't forget to put yourself in, because if we're not 100%, how can you go ahead and help others? So if we can sit quietly, sending out our thoughts and listen to the music that I put on.
Thank you.
Dear Father, Divine Spirit, we thank you for the healing given and the healing received. And as we join our healing energies that have been sent across the world, we also remember our family, our friends, and those that we know that need your support. We also remember the children of the world and the animal kingdom and Mother Earth. And we thank you for our loved ones being safe. We thank you for the love we've received. We thank you for the daily challenges and the sun shining today. And we thank you for the healing given once again. Amen. Thank you. Once again, I pass the service to Heather for the messages. So obviously, if you get a message, if Heather comes to you, you may just lower your mask so that she can hear your reply. So thank you.
I'm actually coming to the lady who's just taken the lunch. So I was nearly going to say, yeah. I've got Mum around you. Can you understand Mum in spirit, please? No, then Grandmother. That's Mum coming in on that loving energy of Mum. And she's saying you're quite a strong-minded person. Do you understand this?
Of course I'm not.
I don't know. So,
yes. Very.
Yeah, but she's saying of late you've been finding that difficult.
Very.
Mm. And it's not just with what's going on in the world. Do you understand that? She's saying you keep thinking back to times. Can you understand this?
No,
she's very much around. You're close to her. She's given me this feeling of closeness with her. You know, like you, if you saw her now, you'd run out and hug her. Yeah. And she's always spoiled you, because I'm getting very emotional from her. I feel that she feels that, and you're in need of it now, she's telling me. Don't give up, she's saying. There's something you've had in mind. Don't give up.
Okay?
She's not talking about now, you know, for... Yes. I have a dog with me as well. You understand the dog? She's got this dog here. I think there was more than one dog, but I do sense one, quite a big dog, going around my legs. It's quite long hair. I don't know. I can't see properly what type of dog. I'm not sure if it's not. Do you understand an Alsatian in spirit as well, please?
Dogs have four legs.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a big one. I'm seeing almost like a German Shepherd Alsatian as well. But this wasn't the only one. There's dogs. There's little ones, she said. And also, I'm getting a budgie flying in around you as well. Do you realise you have healing hands as well, she's telling me? She's talking about healing and healing towards animals and healing towards people. I don't know what you do, so, but this is what she's saying. She's been bringing the smell of baking around you.
That's what I do, that's what I do.
Oh, I don't know. But she's just bringing this...
I'm talking again.
Oh, are you? Oh, sorry. But she's bringing all this baking smells around. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. And she's saying that, which is strange with baking, but she's talking about your back, your lower back hurting you.
Yes.
Yes? And she's saying, you know, and up here, across the shoulders, and you've had enough. Okay, she says, she's doing this. She says, I know. She says, I know. She says, and there's things that need to be said and you want to say. Do you understand? But you've been keeping them in.
I just go like this.
She's saying, that's being wise, but it's not what I would have done.
I wouldn't normally do it.
No, your grandmother would... say it as it was, you know, and you know if everybody scuttled from the room, she'd still say it.
Yes.
And you're a bit like her.
Very much so.
Yeah. So she's being very patient at the minute, and she's telling me you're being very patient at the minute.
Yeah, I just have to do that, and I just say I'm not talking.
But she's saying to me that eventually you will see the change you've wanted.
Okay.
Do you understand this?
But
I will say, she's talking about younger children around you. Do you understand younger children around you? Yeah, she's saying, and she's talking about they can be a handful.
Yeah.
Okay. But she said they're very, very special, and you'll see it one day.
Very.
You'll see it one day. A bit more than you can see it now.
Yes.
I'm getting girls and boys. I'm female and male energy.
Okay.
Do you understand that?
Girls.
Well, I'm getting male energy brought in as well. So if you haven't got the male energy coming in, they will. They will.
Okay.
Yes, okay. She is very much around you, and you're aware to a certain extent of her energy. You get a feeling of her sometimes.
I tend to talk to her when I...
Yes. But she's getting a bit frustrated because she's been tapping things and she's been standing there and your mind's been over-worrying, she's telling me. So she's been standing in doorways trying to get you to look across.
I keep seeing somebody thinking I see somebody.
Well, you weren't thinking you were seeing it's her, because she's actually standing like this. She's standing in doorways. She said, I've tried this. She's tried music. I've tried tapping on the windows. I've tried dreams.
That would make sense now.
Yes. She's been trying to say, I'm with you. And not just I'm with you, but I'm with you in what you're doing. She's put her arm through yours.
Okay.
Thank goodness, she said. Now I've got to stop all this tapping, Lark. But she has been... Have you had a flickering light as well? Okay. Now she's just telling me she's had a go at it. You might have thought, oh, it's just a bulb.
Okay.
But she has really been trying to draw your attention. Stop worrying. Stop worrying. It's not worth it. Stop worrying. Yes, it is easier said, and I understand that because I'm the worst worrier. But yeah, she is saying this. She doesn't want you feeling ill. Can you understand this?
Yeah.
She's telling me that you're feeling drained.
Frustrated.
Do you understand an alarm clock on the earth?
An alarm clock?
She's just showed me an alarm clock. That is ringing really loudly, and if you don't understand that, I take it this way. It's like she's saying to me, you're always on that oomph, ready. You know when you've woken up, you've got to jump out of bed and things like that. But lately you're on that level of that sort of having to race about, and she wants you to relax. She said it's all going to be all right for you and for family, and she thanks you for looking at her pictures. Okay?
Yeah.
Thank you for looking at my pictures.
Yeah.
It's different here. You want to see. You want to see her. You want to see her properly. You want to see. She said it'll take a bit, it takes time, but she says eventually you will have no doubt that it's me beside. Do you understand Dad in spirit as well, please?
Yes.
His Dad's just come in. But Dad's not saying much. Do you understand? He's standing like this.
Women always do the talking.
Do you understand some kind of forces with your dad, please?
Some
forces?
He was in the army.
Yeah, because he's standing like this, very upright.
Yes.
And he didn't believe in this. Not rubbish, 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 you used to say in more words than that.
He'd let us come to it, but
he used to think, excuse the expression, you think people are bonkers. This is what
he never understood.
Yeah, this is what he's saying. He's saying that. But of course, he's getting me to stand like this.
Okay.
You know he's fully 100% behind you?
Yeah, keep talking.
You said you've had low times even before all this happened. Even before this all happened, the lockdown, even before that, before we had to do all these things. He's lifted you up and he's helped you to struggle on. Do you understand his watch, please? Oh, you're wearing it. Ah. Yeah, because he's just pointed me to his watch. He's going to watch. And he wasn't always tactile and he didn't always say what he wanted to say.
Mum did all the time.
Yeah. And he didn't always say he loved you. And he's saying
Never.
Well, he's saying it
but
now.
I know he did.
He's saying it now. He's got me to lean all the way over there. Yeah. I'm saying it now. And he's a deeper voice than mine. So he's saying this now. Black and white picture, keep it close to your heart of him. Wearing his...
I just had it hand-drawn, actually.
Well, he's wearing his peaked cap and he's wearing a uniform.
No, but I know what...
You know which one he's... Yes. It's the one he showed me, a black and white one with the shoulders, peaked cap.
Okay.
And hard life. You understand he's saying hard life? Yeah. He's making up for what he should have done a long time ago and he's making sure it's done right. For you. You've got a sister as well on the earth, please.
On the earth?
Yes, yes, because he's talked about sisters. Yeah, so it's not just for you, it's for everyone, okay? I'm going to move on from him. He does bring cigarette smoke with him. Because he smoked a lot. He's talking about working in the army abroad.
No.
Okay, I've got to find out what he's bringing them aboard for. Do you have connections, family aboard, please?
No.
No, you have to. Oh, maybe I've moved on then. I just will bring your dad in with the smoke.
And
just a minute, please. Thank you. Okay, and a lot of love. All right, because he wasn't always a hugger. So I can feel it coming from his heart to you. So it's like a spirit hug to you. And he's saying, one day you will see everything is going to be all right. Do you understand those words without me going into them? And he's actually blowing you a kiss. Okay.
Thank you.
The reason I am sensing, can anybody understand a gentleman that was in the army that would have gone abroad, Germany, been abroad Germany during the, you know, I'm going back years. And light aftershave, I can smell aftershave with him. Can you understand this gentleman?
Yeah.
So usually they come in and draw me where I'm going, but yes. You can understand. I can smell a lovely, I can't see him at the moment, but he's here. He's just come in, so I do apologise. I can smell the aftershave.
Yeah.
He did like his aftershave.
Spice.
Do you know you could actually smell it going through the house?
Yeah.
He's smiling. Now, your dad is a tactile. He would hug.
Yes.
Because he's giving you a big hug and a kiss. And he's saying you're his number one. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Do you understand him with glasses at one point, please? Because I feel as if I'm looking at with you glasses on.
Yes.
Okay. Now, he's placed the glasses on you, and he's saying, don't strain your eyes.
No.
Do you understand that?
Yeah.
And also, he's saying, early to bed, early to rise.
Yeah.
Now, he's got a lovely sense of humour. He's got a lovely sense of humour. And he is going back to those times. But you, again, there's a lot of people, I think, where we've had this quiet time looking over old photographs. He's saying you've been looking over the photographs, you know. And he's telling me he went suddenly to the spirit world.
He did, yes.
Do you understand heart problems, please? Oh, I see. Yeah, because he's just done that to me as well. He's going to his lungs. He's talking about his lungs.
Oh, right, yeah.
I feel like he was out of breath as well a lot when he was here, and he didn't give up on things easy,
no.
Nor do you.
No.
Do you understand? He wishes he could dance with you again.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
He said that he's gone from all being strong, I was army, to I wish I could dance with you again. Because I feel he had special moments with him with dancing. Okay. Do you understand arthritis in the hands with anyone, please? Or stiff hands?
Yes.
He's bringing that to you. He's saying you're not on your own. You're not on your own. And he's giving you a jigsaw puzzle. Do you do jigsaw puzzles? He's given a jigsaw puzzle to you. And he's saying to me, just a little bit more patience.
Yeah.
Yes? And it's not, we're all impatient to be all right, to get out. It's not, again, it's not to do with what we're going through. It's personal to you. He's telling me you see spirit lights. He said you're very much aware of spirit and almost you can see spirit. Can you understand this, please? You've got a very loving, giving heart. But he's saying lately you've not been given to you. Do you understand the move, please?
Yes.
And it's something that's wanted.
Yes.
Yes. And it's a good move. And he's saying it's about time. Do you understand this?
Yes.
And he's speaking about being more happier for you and the family. He's given me a cigar, so I don't know if you can understand cigars. Your granddad's here with him? That's who placed the cigar on here? Okay. The reason the nails have come through is to give you energy. Give you strength. Yes, your dad's dad, sorry, yes. I should have said, yeah. Yes, you can understand the cigar, yeah. It just was placed in front of me, no words said, you see. And I don't smoke. So they're very much around you at the moment. I'm getting shown a grandfather or grandmother clock as a memory.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And that clock, one of the clocks didn't work properly, the hand was stuck. You can't remember. You were young, okay. Do you understand then the symbolism of being stuck in one place and stuck in one, okay, he's shown that as me. Okay. He wants me to sing, he says you've got a good voice.
Choir.
Ah, oh, you can come and sing. I'm not going to sing, but he's telling me how good your voice is. And they are as well. I've got mum here as well.
My mum sings as well.
Yeah, okay. Is your mum here on the earth, please?
No,
I was going to say, I've got mum here, and I was just checking. Sometimes some grandmothers come through on the mum energy. Just checking, because I can't see her. So it's mum. Thank you, mum. She was a different kettle of fish, your mum.
Gorgeous.
She absolutely is. That's her expression. I'm a different kettle of fish altogether. Don't take any of this nonsense.
No.
Don't listen to all he wants to say.
No.
Listen to me.
Little, you know.
Mighty. I see her as my, I got the word mighty.
Yeah.
Do you understand a cancer condition, please?
Yes.
Was this with your mum, please? Because your mum is talking about it. And she's talking about hospital. Did she pass in hospital, please?
No.
Okay, why are you bringing her hospital passing? Okay, I'll find out in a minute. Can you understand her being in hospital a lot, then? She's given me this feeling of losing a lot of weight. Okay. Do you understand a male that would have passed in hospital?
Yes.
Uh-huh, because I've got two energies come very close. So I've got a male that passed in hospital. It's him that lost the weight. I do apologise. Yeah, and that makes sense to you. Okay. And I'm getting a granddad feeling here. Okay. Do you understand the name of Phil from the spirit world, please?
I've got an uncle Phil.
Yes, because I've got Phil called out to you. He's going like this. Okay. The reason I've... and a Len.
Sorry?
And a Len.
Oh, yes.
Sorry, I'm soft-spoken.
Yes.
Yeah, Elizabeth. Elizabeth, Betty.
Sorry?
Betty. Betty.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Auntie Betty.
Yeah, Auntie Betty. There's also a Gerald.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Yeah, they're all here. Yeah, well, they got the bus. They got the coach. It's a lovely day, isn't it? And it's a lovely day for a trip. And they're talking about a trip for you, but the reason they came in today, these lights thing you're hearing, you're seeing, it will get more and more and more, okay? But the reason they came in today, all of them, was to say that you're very precious and don't think less of yourself. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does, yes.
Especially, you're worth it. You know that, it's like that advert, you're worth it. There's a reason that's very important should you know that you keep on that line that you are. Do you keep your head above with this thought?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you understand this, please?
Yeah.
I want to, they're bringing in flowers to you and I want to leave their love with these flowers. What flowers? they look. Do you understand dahlias?
Yes.
Thank you. Because I didn't know the flowers, they've just told me. Beautiful bunch they're giving to you, and with their love.
Thank you.
Can I come to this lady in the front with the red, please?
Me?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Who's Harold, please?
Harold? Harold. Yes, a friend of mine.
Harold, because I've just got to be given, and I've got an Eric being given, and they're given names at the moment.
Yeah.
Eric, okay.
Yes.
And I've got a Mr. White. I want to go all the way back to when you were a small child, and I'm getting a teacher energy of Mr. White.
Right, it might be Mr. White.
Yeah. Your mum, I've got mum and dad here, I've got an auntie here, and a sense of a sister. Can you understand a sister energy?
Yes.
And they're all very bubbly at the minute, they're all very bubbly, and they're saying put pen to paper, put pen to paper, put pen to paper. Can you understand this?
Yeah.
I've just seen all these papers and it's like, it's been a long time since that pen's been put on the paper.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Well, it was until yesterday.
I was till yesterday. I want to sing White Christmas, but I don't know why. Can you understand I'm dreaming of a white Christmas?
Well, because I play it.
Oh, well, I don't know. But it's been sung beautiful. It's been sung beautiful. They're also putting in front of you, like the piano. It's not piano, it's a
piano accordion.
You know, yes, they're putting that in front of you. Yeah. Who's Derek, please? Derek?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, Derek. Yeah. I've also got behind you, I have got there's a policeman.
Oh.
But it's not a Bobby. I want to go back to, say, 70s or 80s.
Oh, I can't remember that.
It's talking about your dad's side, around your dad's side.
Yes.
Yes, yeah,
yes,
okay. He's talking about you keep losing things, or you keep worrying that you've left a door open or you've not locked it, or...
Yes.
So hence, he's a helper.
Oh, right.
He's come in to help you. Your mum is giving me a beautiful porcelain little dish that you perhaps would put, little pot, porcelain, pretty, painted, that you put jewellery in, women would put trinkets or jewellery in.
Oh.
As memory. And it's all made of, it's like china.
Yeah.
Because there's a love of china. I can see china ornaments everywhere on every shelf.
Yeah.
Do you understand? Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm also getting the old steak and kidney pies made from the basins, you know, they made them at home, homemade.
Oh yeah.
As a memory for you. George is coming in.
Oh yeah.
I'm very quickly going through it because there's just so many here around you giving out their names. So who's Marion?
I didn't know she was in Sperling, but she was.
Do you know Marion here then, please? Because I just
my first sister.
Because Mum is talking about Marion and talking about worry of ill, somebody's not feeling very well around you.
Yeah.
And that you've been asking for prayers and healing on them.
Me.
You as well, but there's somebody around you, it's a female.
Oh, is it? Yes.
Yes. They're just saying not to worry and that your prayers are getting answered, healing prayers are getting answered. You know that song, You'll Never Walk Alone? I'm hearing that song as well for you. You'll Never Walk Alone, that song.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
I've also got a cat, he would have been a captain on captain on a ship.
Oh, yes.
Saying salve to you.
Oh, thank you.
It's very romantic. Can you understand that feeling I'm getting? Oh,
yes.
Goodness. He's so lovely, he's so full of love for you, and he's actually taking his hat off and going like that to you, and I can see him on this big ship and he's the only one on the deck, and he's doing this and he's winking at you.
Oh, my late husband is anniversary today.
Oh, is it? Oh, bless him. And he's very romantic. Oh my goodness, he wants me to come down and waltz with you all around the place. Oh, I can feel it, he's swooning. He's really... I think if I had red roses here, they'd be thrown at you. He's so romantic. But he's very proud of you.
Oh, is he? Thank you.
And you know he's there. And he's... Okay. He's actually given me a bottle of champagne to give to you.
Oh, is he?
Can you understand that?
Well, there's two bottles sitting on the windowsill.
He's a good job. It's making me feel blushed. He's two hearts as one.
Oh, really?
Have you seen that on a card before? Two hearts.
Yes.
Because he's showing me the card. That's why I said it. Yes. Do know he's around you.
I do know he's around me.
Rest your mind, he's saying.
Oh.
Be reassured and know I'm with you.
Thank
I know I'm
so
loving
much.
You always.
Thank you.
He said, and I've stopped smoking.
Oh, no.
Just, you understand that? I don't know if that was... He's got a wicked sense of humour. Goodness, I won't get on him. Do you understand that? One more thing then. Okay, bless him. He's bringing in a cello.
Yes, he used to play the violin.
Oh, sorry, then I apologise. I just saw this him doing this.
Yes.
And I'm not good with my musical instruments. They just show me, and he's still doing it. So he's playing a tune to you.
Thank you.
You're not on your own. He means it. It's not, they don't just say it, they mean it.
Yeah, well, he say all the time, watching me, I know. Yes. I've got to be careful what I do.
He's just said to me, it's not what you do, it's what you think. Leave you with this love as well. Can I come to the gentleman behind, please?
Yes.
Do you understand Mum in spirit, please? I've got Mum here coming
yes.
through too, yeah. And do you understand that she wasn't always there for you as a child? Or she didn't feel she gave you everything as when you were a child? You thought so. She's talking about that she should have given more love or showed more love to you.
Yes,
okay. I feel that it's from her point of view rather than from you. You just saw as well. She's talking about an August month. Can you understand an August month, please? Birthday or an anniversary or passing?
Maybe.
Okay. I do want to tell you, you've got forces gentlemen behind you. I've got army behind you, a gentleman standing behind you. There's about three army. Can you understand army connections, please?
Yes,
that's all right. They're just standing behind you. But again, with that, there's also a navy gentleman that's standing behind you. And he's standing very proud behind you. Do you understand father, please? He's saying, Father, he's given you so much strength. Do you understand that distance with him, please?
Yes.
You didn't really get a chance to know him well. Or he feels that he wanted to get to know you more.
There were things that he didn't.
Yes. So he's also telling me that there's a time and a place for everything. Do you understand that? I don't know if that's how he said, but... He's saying that he didn't always see eye to eye with you. And he said he should have bit his tongue certain times. Can you understand this?
He couldn't.
But do you understand he's saying that? He wants to apologise to you. And he should have done it a long time ago. Do you understand this, please? It's taken... He always thought he was right. Yes?
Yes.
He really, I'm getting emotional. He always thought he was right to the degradation of everybody around him, including you. Yes. And he knows there have been very strong feelings from you and other members of the family towards him at one point or another over time. Can you understand this? I won't say the words, but you understand that, don't you? He's saying that he deserved them, the thoughts. It's taken him a long time, he's telling me, to get to this point. But he sees what he did, what he said was wrong. Can you understand? I keep asking, can you understand? Because it's him asking me to, he wants to hear something.
Yeah.
And it's hard for him here, but he sincerely means sorry. He said, I hope you believe it, I really mean sorry for you, to you and those, and your mum as well. Can you understand this as well, especially saying? He can't make wrongs right, but he can do the best he can for you now. And if you're forgiven, because he's asking forgiveness, I know you have. Sometimes in spirit they come back and they ask again, even though we've already forgiven them, because to make absolutely sure. If you can forgive him again, you will see doors opening for you. And it's not just that they will open because you forgive him. They are opening anyway, but it will be with more of a blessing. He's given me a feeling of passing suddenly with him. He's not telling me how or quick. He's given this feeling it wasn't expected.
He'd been ill for a long time, but not really.
Not really, really, yeah. Yeah. That's it, because he's saying it wasn't really expected, even though it was like... in a strange way, you miss him. Do you understand that? But he's telling me to tell you, he has not gone one inch from your side. I'm not 1 inch from your side. I'm there, and I will be there, and I'll always be there for you. Do you understand drawing, please, at all?
Yeah, he was very good.
I'm seeing these lovely sketches in front of me with drawing. And
yeah, he was very good.
Ah, he says you can do this. You ask him. You just ask him to come in and help you. He said that found him peace. I do feel distance with it again. The Navy is reminding me. I don't know, but he's reminding the Navy. But not just that. There was a distance even when he was at home.
Yeah.
Well, he's very much aware of it. You know, again with him, he was always hesitant to hug. But I do feel this sort of, he wants to try and send you a hug. But it's what's in the heart that matters. It's not what people do, it's what's in there. It brings you comfort. You've been such a good man to everybody. You've done so much for everybody. You do a lot without thinking of yourself. You still do. You're so helpful. He's seen that and you've opened his eyes. You've opened his eyes, and he is really, really proud of you. I mean that. That's what he's coming across so sincere. He really is. I'm getting drawn to ring. Do you understand a ring of your father's, please?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, he's talking about ring. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, he's saying.
It should have gone away.
It doesn't matter, he's saying. It doesn't matter. He's making up for you, okay? But he wants to thank... There's a big picture of him, though. They like the pictures. There's a picture about... framed picture somewhere of him.
It's a sort of painting from the picture.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Because he's talking about that picture. Yes, yeah, yeah.
I used to talk to him a lot.
Yeah. So. Well, he's beside you. Do you understand the harmonica, please? Okay. There's another gentleman from the Navy coming. Do you understand Uncle in spirit, please? No, this is a Navy connection because I'm seeing a harmonica being played.
It might have been one of his brothers. I never knew this time.
Classical music as well has been given to you. Okay, and. When you think back on memories, he understands. He wants you to think forward. And know that those memories are being made with him now, because we can still make memories with those in spirit. Because when we go to the spirit world, they will remember, and we will remember. He loves you. And that's what he came to say. And you're not going home alone, nor are you alone. Can I leave that message with you, please? Thank you. Can I come to the lady in the back, please, with the... Thank you, darling. Thank you. Okay. I've got a grandmother here. Do you understand? Oh, hello. I do know. I've got a grandmother here. I've got an auntie here as well.
Yeah.
Okay. They're fussing around you at the minute. There's a birthday coming up.
I want to go more to June,
July. Yeah, they're fussing. And there's a lot of excitement around. They're on about little ones as well.
Yes.
I can't see... I'm sensing a girl's energy, but there's also a little boy's energy as well around, and there's all this excitement, and I want to take a deep breath. It's almost like you need to take a deep breath.
Yeah,
can you understand that? Oh, they love you to bits. You know that, don't you?
I
know that. I've got Dad here as well.
Yes.
But Dad's just letting go on with it, in a nice way, but he's very close. You're close to your Dad.
Yes, yeah.
In a sense, almost closer to your mum. Like closer to your dad than your mum.
Yeah.
And yet your dad sort of, he's got this sense of humour. He wants me to do my jacket up. I don't. But that's the feeling with your dad.
Yeah,
you understand this, don't you?
Yeah.
So I have, there you are. Now he's talking about paintings and pictures.
Yes.
Paintings? But face paintings?
Yes.
Is this spirit face paintings?
Yeah.
Yes, because he's showing me and they send their spirit. And it's not just that. He says, you've got so many gifts. He's so proud of you.
Yeah.
So, and your mum's talking about things in the house that keep going. Has the washing machine or something gone?
Oh, the washing machine, yeah.
Yeah, because you're saying it's gone a bit funny.
Yeah.
So your mum's more concerned again on the house, and your dad's talking about the mating. Your dad brings in smoke as well, the smell of smoke.
I understand that from the house.
You can understand that. And he wants, again, he wants to come and pick you up and have a dance with you.
Thank you.
He says, no, you're not dreaming. There's a situation, you understand this?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
No, you're not dreaming, he said. No, you're not. Now, he loves you to bits. That's his way. And to the moon and back. Do you understand
yeah,
that
I
phrase?
Understand that.
To the moon and back, he's saying.
Yeah.
Shall I? He said, I can say it again, give her a bit more. To the moon and back. You don't embarrass, I don't want to embarrass you, he said.
That's okay.
Now, with this, is life is very, very different. He's mentioning France. I keep getting France mentioned. I got France.
I understand, yeah.
You understand France? Because as I stood here to come to you, I got France straight away. They didn't tell me why. And also, he's given you fish and chips, but out of wrappers.
Oh,
remember
yes,
when
yeah,
you get the newspapers?
Yeah, yeah.
That's a memory link coming in for you as well. If you sat with him and you picked up a pen, you could write from him.
Yes.
I don't know if you've done that,
yeah,
but he's
yeah,
you have.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he's telling me to tell you it is him. It is him that's helping. And it's helping him on the other side as well, and it's helping
yes.
your family as well. And your mum's saying enough about that. What about the garden?
Okay.
She's
yeah.
given you tulips.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, and I'm seeing pretty pink, sort of pinky colour tulips.
Yeah.
And daffodils, she's saying. Don't forget the
yes,
daffodils.
The
daffodils. Who likes those marabou sweets or the jelly sweets? Because that's.
Which one,
sorry? Is it the jelly sweets, the marabou or something
oh,
like
I
that?
Know which one.
She said, and don't forget those either. She's like, give them to you.
And she liked those.
Oh, she liked them, did she, as well? She says, your place is not as hard to tidy up as hers was.
That's right.
Because
yeah.
I'm getting the feeling with her, she had lots of bits and ornaments
yes.
around.
Yeah.
But she said, her way, she's quite a strong lady, because she'd say her way was her way or the highway sometimes.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you understand this?
Yeah.
Yeah. She's giving you a push.
Yeah, I can understand that as well. Yeah.
And she stands by your bed when you get up in the morning. Not to frighten you, but it's like, come on, come on.
Yes,
do you understand?
Yeah,
come
I
on,
understand
come on.
That, yeah.
We've got the day ahead.
Yeah.
And of course, she's not tired anymore, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
On a serious note, she's saying she doesn't want you losing heart.
Yeah.
She's very much aware of your sensitivity, and she's aware that you've been crying.
Okay.
Yes. She's talking about, do you understand sister in spirits, please? Or the energy of a woman that was like, do you understand long blonde haired woman, very slim? You know, like the 60s, short summer dresses with the sleeve, big bold flowers?
I can understand what you're saying. I don't know who the lady is, though.
Jane. Her name's Jane, because she's come around you.
Okay.
And have you been feeling lack of fun?
Yeah, a bit, yeah.
Because I'm asking this lady, because she's, you know, they used to do all this chiving.
Yeah, that's what it is, yeah, the dancer.
Do you understand that
yeah.
with that? Yeah. But she's around you, she's trying to get you to, you know.
Yeah.
She's very attractive, you know, she's the sort that you'd see one of these Bond films on. She's got red auburn hair. She's got a ribbon tied here.
Yes, yeah.
Bright, bold summer patterns on it. And she's doing all the twisting and putting the music about loud. She wants
yeah,
you
yeah,
to,
yeah
yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah. But her name's Jane, and she's
thank
a witch.
You.
She's around you. She's around you. Now, Dad is saying you are favourite. Do you understand this as well? I hope there's not any others to feel that will feel awful about that.
Well, not here.
That's probably why he's saying it. But he knew how to make you laugh, didn't he?
Yes.
No, yeah, because he's saying it. And he was quite mischievous. Your dad, he would joke.
Yeah.
He's joking a lot.
Okay.
He wants to say to you, hold your hand. you know he loves you. I don't love him the moon about it. He doesn't want anyone to get it back. Yeah. But he's holding your hand. You're not alone. Do you understand this? There is a way through what you're going through. Personal, okay? There is a way through what you're going through. He said, I know you write with me. I know you talk to me. And I know you see me. He said, but sometimes you need more from me. Can you understand this? And he said, you're going to get that more. It's going to come. He wants to thank you for your healing.
Thank you.
And not just for everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
And your mum is coming in, because I've got an auntie here again. She's coming in with you as well. I've got an uncle. I've got a Uncle George?
Yes.
Yeah, and a John?
Yes, there was a John.
Because they're here. And they're talking about happy birthdays. And not just now, but in August.
Yes, yeah.
But there's also a wedding anniversary in between now and going up to September time. They're talking about a wedding anniversary, so it's in between. So it's May. Do you understand May?
I'll have to ask my sister.
The door's not closed.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
Push it open, because they're pushing it open for you. And can I leave their love? Oh, I'm smelling hyacinths as well.
Yes.
And bluebells for you. And also, young man that passed on a motorbike.
Yes.
I'd say he's in his 20s, but it was during, he's got Brute on. I just smell Brute.
Well, Brute was my dad's on the show.
Well, this lad's wearing it.
Okay.
And you understand the lad on the
yes,
motorbike?
I
yeah. And he's revving. And to me, he's when they come in on the bikes and they're revving, it's letting me know that it's the time.
Yeah.
All this smells of this aftershave. A lovely smell of Brute coming through there to you. From Mum and Dad. So I'm getting a song about stars just as I'm coming away from you. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Heather, we're out of time.
Oh, is it already?
Yes.
Well, thank you, Spirit. Thank you.
Thank you, Heather. I was just going to call you to time and then you jumped over to the corner. So too quick you was. So well done. Thank you, Heather. Thank you for a lovely service, and
thank
the energy and the love that comes from you is amazing.
Oh,
so thank you again.
Thank you.
Just to remind you that obviously Laurie is not here today. He's having a Sunday afternoon off, I'll say. But he has put on quite a good programme, a really good programme online, all the different facets that there's meditations, there's lyceums, there's and the Spiritists of Bournemouth on Friday nights and Saturday nights. There's something going on almost every day. So please do, you know, hook into those and enjoy them. Take what you can from them, because they're not there for everyone. But there is something for everyone. So anyway, thank you for supporting Paul Church and supporting Laurie. So I say that. So thank you. So that just leaves me to ask Heather for the closing prayer. Thank you, Heather.
Thank you very much. Can we go into the silence, please? Divine Creator, Great Spirit, we thank you for this service. We thank you for all things, for the blessings and breath of life every day. We thank you for the knowledge that our loved ones are around us, that life is eternal and love is eternal. We pray that light will touch all peoples, healing to all situations, hope, and the ability to aid and assist to in all situations. We pray that the angels will go. We ask and pray for healing in all souls. Those going home may be comforted and healed and feel the freedom of their new life. And please, to those here today or watching, always know your loved ones are around you. Always around you. Always trying in some way or form to let you know they're there. For there is no parting of two worlds. It's just a stepping into another world. So we thank you for this knowledge, dear Creator. May you bless and protect each and every one here, their loved ones, their friends and their family, and all that are listening. May you keep them safe and well until we meet again. And may a blessing always be on those that work so hard to keep the doors open, sanctuaries. A blessing to the doctors and nurses, to those that are working so hard through this pandemic. the volunteers and all peoples, please be with them the strength, the light and the healing. And thank you for keeping us safe each day. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you, Heather. And again, I'd just like to say thank you for supporting the church. Thank you for coming along today, both in the room and online. And I wish you all a lovely week. God bless you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.